All right. Well, let's see how this goes. So we're gonna attempt to run a translator while this whole thing is going. So we have something that will capture the dialogue and Google Translate it. Hopefully not blow up. Also, it's going to be terrible translation, but you know. We'll get the gist. Or maybe not, I have no idea. Depending on the quality of the translation. So Rudy said nothing. Also, decide we're gonna call that mouse fillet. This dude's throwing a party, apparently, though. Yes, Roddy Piper. So the Earl threw a party and invited these people, apparently. Break our bones during the party. But there's no food or music. Also, Gallows is here, apparently. Sup, Rudy? Sup, Comet here, by the way. Intro to Gallows, apparently. A bunch of background on him, probably. Not important. He's just saying he's gonna be later on this story, I think. Because we don't actually recruit him by this point. Oh, this isn't even the party! Uh-oh, we're going to the abyss. I do not want to party in the abyss, says Virginia. Oh, it's not actually going to the abyss, apparently. This is how they're gonna justify having a bunch of weird scenarios. We can go wherever we want with these cubes. He talks too much, so it gets cut off. Okay, we're going to Halloween Town. Now we're talking. Gallows will come because there's free food. Let's have a parry. Campan's game, apparently. The Count is the messenger of love. But no one trusts the Count, except Hanpan. Oh, Hanpan goes nuts! Hanpan thought he was speaking in Chinese. Apparently the Count sucks. Brother Chan's long-legged swordsman brother. It's taking a while for us to just decide to go on this party. Yeah, there's a lot of dialogue, especially when you're slowly capturing it. It doesn't help that it's complete nonsense going through Google Translate. You kind of get the feel of what they're talking about anyways. Like, I was able to go through chapter 1 and 2 and get the gist of what's going on in the actual story. But they do talk a lot. And Hanpan has a weird way of talking, which makes it even harder. Arigato, baby. Probably. Once we get to that part. Translator crashed, hold on. So the Count's down on the fact that everyone thinks he's a pervert, because he is, I guess. Now he's gonna try to guilt trip us into going to the party. Because everyone hates him. So he's saying, go to the party without me, I guess. Virginia's like, what do you think we should do? And I'm going to select the first option because I'm not going to bother translating the options. Rudy says, less. Let's all go to the party. Oh, I guess I called out the Count for fake crying. And everyone's agreeing. But Cecilia's too kind-hearted. Filet's like, no, dog. Probably, anyways. Yeah, she's like, no, dog. He's just gonna go to the party, regardless. Powerful cyclone system that invites opponents without question. Alright, so it's gonna take us whether we like it or not. It's already too late. We are captured. It's like that time in a gate generator. When the gate goes out of control. It's good noise. Alright, we're slowly getting sucked in. Woo! Oh, Gallows is gonna survive. No, he isn't. And we got a gem. Alright, should we just watch the next scene? How many scenes are there? Okay, 5 scenes. Alright, break up the action. Let's, do some gotcha. Let's, get rid of that thing. Alright, so as part of the Halloween event, you can get these Halloween tickets, which you need to get 20 to get everything, I guess? And I have 10. So, let's, burn through these 10. Mirabelle. Alright, what's in the box? What's in the box? Got a gear ticket. Oh, oh! 5-star! Oh, that's an arm. Wait, never mind. It's a gear upgrade. Gotta watch the animation each time, of course. Ooh! It's a useless arm, but cool graphic. I don't remember if I already have that one or not. Oh, Maribel! 5-star! Wait, that's a different colored box, isn't it? Oh! Oh! Oh, never mind. 20 duplicators, I guess that's legit. We didn't get the character, though, we just got the arm. To be clear. Ooh. Fancy box. I can't remember which box is colored good. What's her name? This one looks fancy. I have zero memory. Well, which one's the good box? Ooh! Oh! Okay, 5-star. Gear. Getting a lot of gear. Just a bunch of gear heads. I think this is a 3-star one. Alright, those are our tickets. Labyrinthia, that's right. We gotta finish that game. I'll probably finish chapter 3 tomorrow. I had to go away for a Thanksgiving, Canadian Thanksgiving, last weekend. Those are tickets where we can get 10 more somehow. Current gear gotcha for a bunch of Halloween items, but whatever, you know? You know? Because there's a Cecilia gotcha. So the first 11 pulls have 300, so we're gonna do that. So we're gonna get 11 potential Cecilia cards. There's two that we want. Two 5-stars. So pray for 5-star. Doesn't look like there's any 5-stars. We get a Jack, Brad, Janice, 4-star Jet, 3-star Cat, Neuter, Felix, Janice again, Sword Princess, Genus, Rudy. Alright, so step 2 is 500. Let's do a single pull. He seems pretty stoked about this one. Oh! I think it charged longer. Never mind. And we didn't get a single sausage on the Cecilia. Four star anyways. Yuli. That's all of our arm tickets. So here's the ultimate struggle. There's a Cecilia gotcha, and here's what we can get. We got the 5-star Cecilia cutting her hair. And 5-star Cecilia leaving father's grave. But then there's the Halloween arm gotcha where we get pumpkin Cecilia. But also a bunch of other stuff we don't really care about. So which one do we invest in is the question. Better chance against Cecilia here. Then we miss out pumpkin Cecilia. So let's do one of each, I guess. No 5-stars there. Oh, we got Clarissa. Dude. Cat. Girl. Raquel! Him. Jack. I think I do need Pumpkin Cecilia. That's pretty good Cecilia, too. That's also pretty good Cecilia. Hey, Rebecca again. That's... because I can only do one more 11 pull. Pumpkin Cecilia. Double Cecilia. Which one ends first? Okay, this one ends sooner. Alright, let's go for Pumpkin Cecilia. Please, God. Don't make this a mistake. God damn it! That's why gacha games are the worst. 33 pulls, not a single 5-star. No one cares, no one cares. Feel when no pumpkin Cecilia. She'll always live in our hearts, though. Handing out candy. So that's all the gachas for now. So let's get back to the story. Probably should have spaced that out a bit more. Because there's a whole lot of story left. But everyone loves a good non-canon Halloween event. Well, maybe it's canon now. Alright. Oh, Jesus. Oh, man. He's got a Halloween getup. After this story of Japper, we'll do some combat. I gotta upgrade all the Mirabeau cards. It's gonna be a pain, it takes a while. We can demonstrate that a bit later, I guess. She says something. Alright, it's time for everyone to change into their Halloween clothes. I wonder if Hampan and Filet will get costumes. Alright, we're agreeing to wear the costumes. Because it's easier that way. Oh, is there costumes for Hanpan? Or again, some windmills? Alright. Enough with the suspense. I know what most of them look like just from the pay to win costumes. Well, not pay to win, they're useless. Alright, we got Virginia, Rudy, Dean, Pumpkin Cecilia. Also Pumpkin Filet. Dean is rocking the six pack. Thank you, Either. If only we could have got Pumpkin Cecilia. Oh god! Power Bobo. Power Bolt. I don't think that's what he actually said. We got Pumpkin Hanpan as well. When you don't know what to wear to Halloween, wear a pumpkin. This smelly guy, this is a devil. So villagers were pumpkin people all along. The count's probably gonna feign ignorance. I got screwed on the gacha, did not get Pumpkin Cecilia, so all was lost. On the contrary, it is thought that this is also thought that it was proved the height of your insight that has been looking forward to being deceived in advance. Of course. Alright, we gotta defeat the jack-lanterns. So Don't worry, I'll spend $200 and we'll get We didn't get a single sausage either, just no 5 stars. Jeff Lantern, excuse me. Oh, there's more of them. So we can eat the jack-o'-lanterns after we kill them. Virginia's outfit is okay, but kinda bland. Not very Halloween-y. The other ones look stupid. Pumpkin Cecilia's the only good costume, other than the Wind Mouse ones. Gallows is just gone. It is expensive, I'll give it that. No one knows that Gallows is no longer with him. As they should. Oh, he got teleported somewhere else, even though Higuchi said there would be no faults with the teleportation. So where's those jack-o'-lanterns just, like, standing around? Waiting for us to finish this overly long conversation. Alright, here we go. Meanwhile... Gallows is pretty bummed out. He's alone in the wilderness. Oh god, we still get... I thought I was gonna end there. Oh Jesus, oh Jesus, it's her. I don't think we actually, I think we might recruit her by the end of the Halloween event. I assume there's a second half. Cause this part ends at 10:16. Alright, let's do some battles. Oh wait, we have to watch scene 5. That's a bit of ways. We'll demonstrate the controller mapping I made for this game. No support. You got this. You can see I've totally been grinding and not at all running a macro to get all the event items. Apparently they improved the loading. Seems like it might be better. So how this game is controlled, it's a touchscreen. But the controls are very action-oriented, so touchscreen controls, especially with a mouse, aren't great. So instead I've used a PS4 controller to map the mouse to a circle here. And I mapped a button to click. This is generally how I move, and it's pretty smooth. Also mapped a button to open the arm menu, then three other buttons to select each of the arm options. Button to use force ability, then another button to lock on. Also do the slide easily. Oh god! I forgot to lock the mouse input. There we go. The problem with the slide input is that it can easily send your mouse off screen, which is not what you want. We might actually die here. Probably should have took someone with me. Do we have any good arms? Nothing that heals. We'll have to... This isn't the right way. Where are we going? This way? Okay. Probably should have opened those chests, but whatever. Have stopping power with regular moves for Rudy. So Rudy was our best option, so we're probably gonna die pretty quickly here. So Expert isn't playing around, apparently. See, I should have took a partner in. I underestimated Expert. Clearly. Yep, more Wild Arms Million Memories. No translation. Oh, I gotta get rid of that. Well, that's the one bad thing with the current setup. Oh crap, I didn't mean to revive there. I should make it like after 20 seconds it'll automatically disappear, just in case I forget, like I always will. Let's get Rudy back in here. He's our man. Jack-o'-lantern. You got this, though. Let's give him a taste of our arms. He's got a decent amount of health, actually. What about this? I think that should have worked. Okay, yeah, these controls are way better than what I had before. Give him some of that, Rebecca. It's over for you, Jack Lantern. Jeff Lantern. Quest cleared. We already got enough EP to get all the event unlocks, though. So, how the events work is that you get a bunch of EP every fight. And sometimes these things load. Okay, there we go. And then the more EP you get, the more unlocks you get. And what I got this time around was a bunch of this. Basically, a bunch of tickets. Okay, on to scene three. Probably didn't need to translate that bit. Alright, we got some of them, but there's more in the back of the village. Everyone has become powerful. Crap, another crash. Gotta purchase a license so that it wouldn't crash so often. Okay, we missed a couple of dialogue, but that's fine. He's spitting some real game there. So this guy created the jack-lanterns. The plaque market. Brittany wasn't invited to the party, or she ignored the party invite, actually. She made the wise decision. Because she doesn't trust the Earl. Only these people were stupid enough to come to the party. Villagers are no longer in the village. It's good, I guess. So either the villagers or we are going to a hot spring after this. And that's probably a trick to convince us to follow along. Still got more jack-lanterns to fight. Some sort of boss will show up on Halloween or something. So, oh, Marivelle. We gotta clear out all the jack-lanterns before she arrives. Not sure why. Not sure what that is. These people are talking nonsense. She's 1,000 years old or something. So the plan is, capturing this dialogue and getting it all Google translated. And then eventually getting actually translated. But that's not for today. Mirabelle assumes Gallows is a pervert. Because he was alone in the woods. Which is a good call, I guess. Yeah, Lizanard would be incomprehensible. Since she's a vampire, she sleeps in her castle. I assume that's what bad guy was supposed to translate to. Oh, she goes to the village on Halloween to get candy, I guess. So God's food is candy. Now she's gonna be mad because there's no villagers to give her candy on Halloween. Because of the Earl. Dynamism reverse! That's totally what she said. Alright, got a gem. Alright, let's keep rolling. We gotta see the fifth scene to unlock the next battle, so. They just keep coming. Girl's freaking out about not killing them in time for Halloween. Probably because Mirabelle will eat him or something. First option. We think we should do that. Dean is impressed by me selecting the first option. Rudy was probably like, let's just burn the whole village down. Rudy's going full Arthas on this one. Oh, the villages will burn. Oh no, Rudy actually did go full Arthas, I was joking. Oh, we gotta destroy the monster spawners. Maternal. Alright, we gotta destroy the roots. Yeah, we're getting new sides to Rudy in this game. Just omnicidal. We gotta cut the root of evil. Marivelle is coming soon. There will be hell to pay if she doesn't get her candy. We should just buy candy or steal all the candy from the houses. They probably didn't take their candy with them to the hot springs. We're thinking we should just defeat the monster. And the count is like, nah, you can't do that. Not sure if it's because we had get done in by Marivelle, or he doesn't want us killing Marivelle, or would obviously know that we wouldn't kill Marivelle upon seeing her. It's just a regular human. Well, somewhat regular human. So they also have the same idea. Stoked or shocked about this whole thing. He finds out she's legendary. I guess. Thank you, Rudy. Farewell. Jinx continues to ensue. So Gallus wants to marry Marivelle for some reason, maybe. Marivelle's not having it. There's nothing to do. Ooh. Alright, I think that's scene four. Now, one more scene, then we unlock. There's six scenes. Oh, the battles unlock after scene five, anyways. We'll be able to do some more battling. I assume scene six is the finale? Question mark? Talking way too much. We should probably make it so that you can see that last line. That's for next time. Oh no, there's more of them. Oh, they're running away though. Because they saw many we killed, probably. Oh, they're defending the towers. They're burning something. Not sure if there's someone getting sacrificed. Wait, the root is burning? Isn't that what we wanted to do? Oh no, there's a bunch of pumpkins. Okay, so probably Marivelle is the one that burned it, or Gallows. But that means that Marivelle's already here. Tried to brag about saving the village by himself, but this is probably mostly Marivelle. Uh-oh, Marivelle is here! Does that mean we fight her? Uh-oh. It's playing the game over music. Exactly. Oh no, there's gonna be a nightmare. Cause she's not getting her candy. She's so taken aback she can't even speak Japanese. He's asking where all the villagers went. Says something that shocks her, that's for sure. Alright, so they know each other. And Maribel is mad at the Count. We're driving away all the villagers. Alright, we're gonna fight her. Plan B, in effect. Oh, first option. Don't know if I agreed to fight her or not. I assume we'll end up fighting her either way. Uh-oh. She's got her thingies. Alright. Let's fight Maribel. We'll take some backup. We don't need backup, actually. Yeah, the choices don't matter. They probably affect the next couple of dialogue lines. So it's annoying when you're trying to translate the game. Yeah, let's get rid of the stuff. Yeah, we'll see what she's got. It's in the chest. More EP. I don't need it though. I wonder if I did that fight faster, they wouldn't have spawned. Probably not. Probably all set. Ow. They're slowly killing me. I need a heal spell, probably. Let's send in Virginia. Actually, let's send in Jack. He probably won't last long, but... there he goes. Virginia. Business. Okay, so if you're in the back row, you heal. That's good to know. Oh man. Aw, crap. On to target. Need to take care of this ad real quick. Oh, it's not gonna be quick. Okay, no more lock on. We gotta. Oh man, we're screwed. We're gonna need to have a assist character. Alright, let's bring in the big guns. Was that like the White Arms 2 song? Alright, bring in the level 53. No more messing around. It's really hard to do boss fights in this game when there's multiple targets. Go, Rebecca. Yeah, let's see if the second wave spawns. Yeah, okay, it does. Alright, let's try this again. So she's probably the more dangerous one. Let's go for her. Alright, Rebecca's already dead. That's not good. This is gonna be rough, I'm not gonna lie. Friggin' pots. Ow. Yeah, Rebecca died pretty quickly. She was kind of a punk. Ow, 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 ow. Get out of there. Oh no, you're paralyzed. Rudy! This isn't fair. Alright, we need to get Rudy some healing. It's gonna take a while. Gotta make sure we don't actually take that gem. Alright, we're back in, Rudy. Yeah, I wonder if it'd be better. That was a mistake. All right, you're back in Virginia. All Yeah, we definitely need a healing arm for Rudy. It's a big oversight. Ow. Just gonna. We should probably be using arms, actually. That's gonna be a major source of damage. I assume that hit. Maybe not. Oh crap. Crap. No paralysis! Alright, we're gonna have to use a Gimmel coin. Wanna save those as much as possible, but. Why are you running away? Gimmel coin it is. We have 36, so. Friend Rebecca is back. For now. Yeah, I got a ludicrous amount of Gimmel coins, so it's not a huge sweat. I would like to use as few as possible. Did that too early. Gotta get out of here, Rudy. Back to Virginia. Ow. Almost got one shot there. Oh, Jesus. That went well. Alright, let's pick up a gem here. Ow. Did we already pick up the corner gem? Alright, get back in there. Oh, we didn't. Well, that was a waste. And level 53 Rebecca does not have any health. She probably has terrible arms. It's ludicrous. Oh yeah, arms. Good call, good call. Alright, then give her the dangerous object. Alright, she's down. Now it's just this pumpkin. Yeah, we also got a force ability. Not really sure what it does. It says boost attack, so I assume it do more damage, yeah. Guess we shouldn't be too cavalier. Let's try getting a knockdown. Yeah, once it's a single target, you can just stun spam, so it's no big deal. Well, bam! Only took like 4 coins or whatever. What we got there? I assume this is the expert version. So, we need a real ringer for this one. Level 64, that's pretty good. 67. 70. Oh man! Dude! 85. 84. Ooh. Which one's better? Rank 41. This. A lot of defense and attack. Yeah, this seems like the best option. Yeah, the... It seems like your level gives you a percentage bonus on your stats, and then your arms and gear determine your stats. So, because Rudy's arms and gear are way better. He's gonna be our go-to. So I assume the expert version is the exact same mission, but harder. Hence the need for a level 85. 84, actually. So let's hope that Virginia can sufficiently carry us. Seems to be the case. We'll see once the actual boss starts. Yeah. All the gacha stuff. Characters come for free, so. And you get a bunch of arms and gear from the actual events, but I'm guessing the ones you get via gacha. Oh wait, there's no boss encounter? This is the boss room. Maybe it's after this fight. Probably the gacha gear and arms are way better in stats and actual attack. Okay, here we go. Ow. At least there's no ad. Actually makes this a bit easier. Other than the fact that I got 2 shot. That's fine. '85 Virginia's doing her work. I'm only doing fractions of her damage, no big deal. Alright, while I lay on the ground, I won. Yeah, I haven't actually checked what the relative worth of the welfare epics are, as it were. S rank! Friend that person. Probably is on full friends list by now. Oh no! Nice. Alright, so that's all the battles for the event. Now we just have final scene. I assume the final scene anyways. So this is after we defeat Marivelle, who's raging about candy. But plot-wise, she was the one that bested us, apparently. Classic Wild Arms. Gallows is pretending he was a part of the win the fight. She's gonna go all out. Oh no, she's probably gonna summon Asgard. Well, they have actual Asgard. This body of copper was born. Oh man, what type of Asgard is it gonna be? In this murderer of cannons. Ignore that translation. Maybe we're not going to actually see Asgard. Okay, apparently everything resolved itself. Okay, we're all going to the hot springs to meet the villagers. Got nothing to do with what the Count did. Let's all kill the Count, is why I'm getting out of this. Sick of the Count by this point. You still mad about not getting candy? The Satome School. Ultimate technique. Not really sure who's talking at this point. Oh, bunch of villagers. Hey, it's the villagers. They get actual art. They're back in time to give Marivelle candy. Oh, Jesus. Hmm. Wait, is that the guy? Yeah, it is the guy timed out. Alright, there we go. Much better. That guy I had to time out last time, too. He's trying to be funny. There's no humor allowed on this stream. I have a separate program running that is capturing the dialogue and translating it. Then I'm just putting it on the OBS through capturing that program and putting it above the actual mobile game capture. So it's all through Movie Magic. And they're giving the Count candy too, even though he destroyed their village, kind of. But these villagers are pretty chill. Not the perfect solution because it kind of cuts off the text if it translates too long. Also, the translation is pure nonsense, so you only kind of get a gist of what's going on. We have to prepare for Halloween! Oh, they're just stoked about starting Halloween. And it was all according to plan. Real side eye going on. Count is trying to wrap this up smoothly, even though he was the cause of all this. Called Marivelle Monster. I don't think we're gonna unlock Marivelle as a character. For no other reason, I would expect to have seen some screenshots on Twitter. Nah, it's a Million Memories character. Count of Pagucci. The same name as the arena owner in Wild Arms 1 and probably all the Wild Arms, so he is the Count of this game. But he probably runs an arena, maybe. He's the one that funds the Blue Caravan, which is the main party of Wild Arms Million Memories. But he's a bit of a troll. Souvenirs for Avril and Rebecca. And we'll all go back next year. If this game is still running next year. And And we're gonna return to the real world. Who was that mysterious red-eyed girl? It's weird that the Halloween event... Does Halloween happen early in Japan? Because this ends on the 16th. And it's a touchscreen game, which I had to improve by mapping all the controls to a PS4 controller. So I'm not sure how it's tracking. Did we abandon the count in this village? I'm not really sure what's going on here. It's October close enough. Yeah, maybe. Alright, and that's the Halloween event. Let's see if we got anything special. Oh yeah, we gotta clear the dialogue. Breaks the movie magic when you see that, it really is just an overlay. We got another Halloween ticket. I'm not sure how we get the rest, because supposedly we can get 20. Yeah, let's cash in that Halloween ticket. Not a single Cecilia, other than the low-tier Cecilia. That looks like a fancy box. Oh! Oh! Getting a lot of 5-star gear, anyways. Probably decent odds of getting 5 stars from that ticket exchange, though. So these are our arms. I have more arms than this. I definitely have more arms than this. Are they in my mailbox? Because I can't have any more arms. Okay, yeah. So yeah, I kind of have an insane amount of arms, because the arm upgrade cards also count as arms in your slots, so... Gonna have to get rid of a bunch of those at some point. Yeah, cleared that event. Kind of partway through chapter 5. And we get Cecilia. So they released one new chapter from the initial 8. There's chapter 9. We'll go a bit here. See what's going on here. At some point, we'll unlock Rebecca and Dean, and then Cecilia in chapter 9. See what Cecilia's like, though. So I've only translated chapter 1 and 2. So I don't know the story leading up to this point. Don't really remember what we're doing either. And at some point I'll put the whole documents online somewhere. Maybe try to get some real translation effort going on. Exposition of the exposition. That kind of sums up everything, don't you think? Oh, we're admiring the team effort of Dean and Rebecca. But we're not going out. I'm never bored when I'm with you, Anthony. There'll always be crazy things happening when I'm with you. I'm translating the Google translation. That's because you head into danger all the time. They instantly understand the type of anime relationship this is. Alright, Cecilia, what's up? Oh nice, she's got some real range to her. Oh Jesus. Alright, Cecilia's god tier. We already knew that, but... Look at that range. Alright. It's a boss pill bug. Oh wait, we gotta get rid of that, There we go. We have to add a timeout to that. Keep going, Cecilia! Kill everything! I'll help. The only robot is Rudy. I can't remember if Jet's a robot, actually. I don't think Jet's a robot. That was a legit Cecilia. Is Jet a robot? Time remembering. Oh Jesus Christ. It's Tall Man. I can't remember. Tall Man has appeared already. I don't remember what his role is. Apparently we're looking for children. Probably Dean and Rebecca. Guess we ran away from the village. It's you and me, Rebecca. Conquer the world. For another quest. Dean still has a shovel, because he should receive his arms from Avril, and we haven't met Avril yet. Dean wants to help the village. Tom ends like, why? That's just because Dean's a good guy who can't button up his pants, apparently. Okay, everyone in the hill village hates migratory birds, apparently. Which are drifters. Migratory crow. Drifters aren't allowed in Surf Village. I assume he's still the mayor of Surf Village. Yeah, looking forward to the renewed love triangle. I half think there's a love triangle with Rudy, Virginia, and Brittany, but I haven't translated that far. There's all new potential for love rhombuses and love geometry. Tall Man's a dictator. There's injured people in the caravan. I can't remember who's injured. It's Clarence? I think Clarence is injured. No, I Brittany. Brittany or Clarence. One of them's injured. But Tall Man's a prick, so he's not gonna let us in. So Dean's gonna yell about something. All you got is a shovel, dude. Is that him brandishing his shovel? Oh! You can do anything as long as you don't give up! Dean. Signature line. Virginia, instantly impressed. I will never give up on Olay. I'm liking the Google Translate version of this story. I think Jack is one step away from just going yari yari daze. If you know what I mean. That looks like a choice is coming up. Will we take Dean with us? Yes. I think that's yes. Rebecca wants to go too, because Dean is going. With her crazy, crazy outfit. With her acrobatic shooting. Only she can handle Dean. Gong cherry block. Sometimes the translator explodes. I'm not entirely sure why. Rebecca's being all tsundere. Let's see if I run the translation again, will it come out better? Apparently not. Gem! 1/500th of the way to another 11 pull. Alright, who are we taking with us? Heh. Love Lady Rebecca looks pretty legit. Remember to clear the screen. Yeah, Zach and Rudy. Roddy? Not really sure how to pronounce it. Jack and Rudy work better, I think. More translation, actually. It was a lie! Yeah, WoW 5 already canonized the fact that everyone exists in the same world, except different versions of the same world, or same people. This game's doing a decent job of merging everyone's prologue, so that's still technically their prologue. Like, Rudy saves a village, but is banned from the village because he used an arm. And the same village is where Virginia's from, and Virginia joins Rudy and flies away, and they defeat a gob. So it all works out with both prologues there. It's a weird looking pill bug. I've never seen that type of pill bug before. This guy's a master of a monster. Leave it to the ladies. What? Wish there was a version of Dean with a shovel. Take that, pink pill bug. Oh wait, dialogue's still on the screen. Oh dang, there's not. Whoop, missed what Dean said, but that's okay. We'll live. Rebecca is totally on board with Dean. Or I mean Virginia. Oh man, there's gonna be crazy love polygons. Everyone in love with everybody. Except Jack. We did it. Yeah. Friggin' so many things to translate. F513, really? Pouring back that we killed the beast, which was a pink pill bug. Were they really afraid of a pink pill bug? The beautiful, beautiful, and natural beauty was properly destroyed. Freaks out. Oh. This guy is still being a tyrant. But he's also a doctor, so he's gonna look at the injured person. So it all worked out. Brittany the one that's injured? I can't remember. Okay, Clarence is the one that's injured, okay. Wait, is this the Surf Village theme? / Rudy theme? No, I don't think so. Heard a twinge of it. It'll be interesting if this OST gets released. So Clarence is gonna heal, or we're heading to Adelheid. Because Riritia is there. Brittany's now the head of the Blue Caravan! But he's gonna still be an Armeister. So is Clarence leaving the blue caravan? Oh, he's gonna stay here for a while. Brittany agrees. Doctor Engineer. For some reason they translate Emma to Engineer, so it's always weird when Emma pops up. Roth. I imagine Dean and Rebecca will join us. Alright, we're gonna leave Clarence in the village. Brittany's now the head of the blue caravan. Jack's saying something. Twin Tail Alliance. Oh, we're going to the festival. Nothing bad could possibly happen there. We're going to Adelheid to see the Arm Festival, or Ruin Festival. And Dean and Rebecca. Brittany wants them to come too. And I think they agree. He's talking about how legit his shovel is. The Black Fenrir, or the Bracket Furrier. No one's impressed by a shovel, though. We got Rebecca! Alright, let's see how buff we can make Rebecca. More plot. Alright, we're at Adelheid. Adelheid's a lot bigger in this game. Well, I imagine that's how big Adelheid actually is. But not properly represented in the games because video games. Set power. We got the English version of Million Memories. Dean's freaking out. He's never seen this many people before. into preparing for the fair. Alright, are we actually gonna fight Belzelk? Because that's what the fair is for. And Belzelk's statue was found previously. We gotta head out and look for Emma. So it'll be harder to find her once the fair starts. Asking Fillet if she knows where the engineer place is. Only Clarence knows, and he's injured somewhere. We're gonna treasure hunt for the engineer place. Virginia is always permanently stoked. Let's all find Emma. Rebecca's probably being all emo because Dean likes Rebecca or Virginia's suggestion. Or she wants to walk with Dean. Friggin' Rebecca, dude. I don't know what she's thinking. Is gonna bogart Dean here. Jack and Rudy are gonna partner up. Because they need to be together when they meet Cecilia. I can see where this is going. We can totally pick up girls if we're alone. It's more or less what he's saying, I think. The grass is always greener for Jack, apparently. Or I guess everyone's like 10 years younger than him. Have you forgotten where your ribbon came from? We don't know where his ribbon came from in this world. Obviously from Elmina, but I'm not sure how that plot will play out. Mysterious villager. Does everyone know that Rudy's a robot? Probably not. Is it Cecilia? It's gonna be Cecilia! Oh! Are you 10,000 journeys? This is probably her coming up and saying, are you an adventurer? Do you want to go to Lilithia's tomb? Basically a dialogue she gives when she's recruiting people. So apparently she also had her vision quest already. So that's chapter 5 done. Onward and onward, I guess. Oh wait, we forgot to power up Rebecca. Oh, do we actually get Cecilia's prologue? Well, we're not translating up there, so... It says something. Shrine Priestess. Oh, this is totally Sturdark. Does that mean we fight? No, Jesus. We more or less know what's going on here, though. Oh, innocent one, give me your name. I'm a guardian. Guardian beast. Yes. What is my name? And what's not? Hopefully there's not a whole lot of dialogue up there. I'll have to figure out a different way if so. Talking about the teardrop. Maybe the teardrops relate to arms in this game, because they also give a blue glow. Probably not important. Or is she not even going to go to the sealed library? It's like, yo, seek out Lilithia. We don't got time for the sealed library. Yep, alright. That's a simplified Cecilia prologue. Riritia, what does it mean? Let's ask about Riritia. He's a space case. The Clan Abbey. Close enough. Brittany found Emma, I think. She's also looking for a Riritia. We should take her with us. Gem! Alright, let's power up Rebecca. See how much we can boost her. Maybe we should have saved those for Cecilia. Oh well. Crap, we gotta assign all this stuff. We want a good healing spell. Yeah, whatever. We'll deal with that later. Don't wanna be messing around too much. With all that crap, because it takes forever. We'll do that off stream at some point. Alright, Rebecca's set up. Scene 2. Emma! First time she's seen so many customers. There's a lot of people at this point. We got quite the crew. So she's working on the Lilithia coffin, but there has been a complaint about something. Although we haven't actually caused an earthquake in this game, so... some naturally terrible stuff happened. I assume Emma said something important. guessing she wanted to talk to Clarence and is annoyed that he's not here. Man, she's... I don't think my translator captures that far into the line. The coffin of the religion is serious. We reach here, Dato. We reach here. I like all the different translations of Ruridia coming up. Emma's freaked out by the reaction. So he's freaking out. Rebecca's freaked out by Cecilia. Like, who'd Rudy bring with us? She gonna reveal she's a Cress sorcerer. Or Cresso One Saras. Shouldn't Emma know who Cecilia is? Maybe not, she was in the Abbey for 17 years. As we're looking for Lilithia, so she's gonna manipulate us to do her work. That is true. Emma doesn't pay attention to anything else. So was there an earthquake or just monsters? Okay, just monsters, no earthquake. So, even if Rudy never caused the earthquake, it still would have gone bad. Oh, she dug too deep. She's getting all evil and stuff. Dean, being an excavator, is pretty stoked about this. Rebecca's like, Dean, get away from that female. Or maybe she's complaining about Dean. I'm not predicting Rebecca's dialogue well. I'm flanderizing her a bit. Oh yeah, Dean does love golems. Oh wait, she introduces herself as Dean's girlfriend? That can't be right. I don't know what's going on anymore. Cecilia wants to go too. Jackie obviously wants to go, and he's like, yeah, Rudy will go with us. Rudy's not as stoked about this whole thing. Oh wait, I get to choose if he's stoked. Yes, I am stoked. She'll pay us properly. We'll have enough money to enjoy the festival. Surely nothing will go wrong before we can enjoy it. Alright, we can get past those guards now. Oh geez, that's the advisor. Can't remember his name. Joheim? Johan? Johan? Johan. It's Johan, Minister Johan. Searching for the princess. Guess she's supposed to come back from the Kern Abbey by this point. Balloons. Everything will go dandy. Alright. Only one option for support. I guess we have to take Cecilia. Crest Sorcerer. Oh wait, that means they have a model for Robe Cecilia? Huh. I wonder if once you get Cecilia you can choose the costume. They better not make you pay for Robe Cecilia. Because you definitely get her as Adventurous Cecilia. I didn't see anyone posting anything about Robe Cecilia. Alright, Cecilia, let's roll with your staff clipping into your hair. So this is Rolithia's coffin. Dean's gonna be useless because he only has a shovel. But he's pretty confident in his shovel. And Jack is looking for the absolute power. So does that mean Jack is from Arctica and was killed the demons? Or had to outrun the demons? Will we ever know? Well, there are models for all the event costumes except Cecilia. But you have to buy them. I like range characters. Let's see what the charge attack is like. Oh nice, you get the swan kick. I was pretty disappointed when I saw you had to pay for him. Maybe Pumpkin Cecilia, you won't have to. And we were able to map all the controls to a PS4 controller, so this is actually somewhat playable now. I should try this on an actual smartphone, see how good it is. It's the boss gob. Or just a bunch of them. Eat arm! Oh crap, we had the dialogue up the entire time. Alright, next stream we're gonna have a timeout for the dialogue, in case I'm dumb. Wait, there's another battle right after? I wonder if we'll fight the Mag Tortoise. Seems like the way it should go. Alright, any Cecilias? See some Dean. Oh geez, it's Halloween, Dean. Translation. Guardian defends secretive citizen Sturdark. So she's wondering what's at the end of Riritia's coffin. It's quite the music. Rebecca's run is crazy. Like the dainty hand out in one side, then holding a gun in the other. No Meg Tortoise? That's weird. Although maybe we're not at the end of the tunnel yet. Yatta! S rank! Yeah, sure. Friend and everyone. How many scenes are? 'Still a lot more to the tomb. So, still time for Meg Tauris to make an appearance. Break time! Let's have some sandwiches. Your magic is very stubborn. It's a real backhanded way to say it. To have an adventure before she becomes a princess for reals. Jack's not stoked about having Cecilia around. Or maybe he is, I don't know. Once he finds out she's a princess, he will change his tune. is like, I also ran away from home. We'll be best buds. Alright, back to adventure. Any Cecilia? Don't see many Cecilias out there. Another friggin' gob. The real economy of models in this game. S rank. I'll probably get S ranks for everything because I'm just way more powerful than I expect you to be at this point in the game. Mission clear! 10 friends. Or 10 followers. Or follows. I wonder if I have any followers. Probably not, because I'm not super high level. California. Don't know how that happened. Something weird is happening. A giant is buried in the floor! Oh wait, are we gonna see? Which version is it? It's ACF, it looks like? Yeah, ACF, Lolithia. Wait, I thought Lolithia was gonna be Avril. There's two Lolithias. So Lolithia is a giant machine. All right, this theme is pretty good. We had the soundtrack of this game tonight. Jack is disappointed because he can't fight with a giant machine. Must acquire absolute power. Oh, the teardrop shining. Oh, geez. Uh-oh. So a teardrop formed a ball of light. Dean and Rebecca being in the shot makes me think that the ball of light is going to become Avril. So Avril and the machine are the same? Question mark. It's her with the arms, so Dean can fight. She sleeps in her tomb. Yeah, she literally was called Lilithia in Wild Arms 5. It wasn't translated to that, but when you fight her in the Avril's mind, her name is Riritia, the Ice Queen. It's the most disappointing part of the Wild Arms 5 translation. Avril is at a loss for words. Johnny Appleseed! Oh man, I hope Avril is canonical. I mean, she has to be canonical, Avril. This is just the latest time loop and it got a bit weird. Avril is basically the only hope that this might become canon. This is just the latest loop. Johnny Appleseed isn't her name, but it is important. So we got all the main characters from Wild Arms 1 and Wild Arms 5 now. And one from Wild Arms 3. And that's it, I guess. Is that really all we have? Yeah, I guess so. So we got all the best characters. Well, characters from the best games. So, Silly is wondering why she was sent here to get Avril, I guess. So this is pretty similar to the dialogue that happens in the Wild Arms 5 prologue. Rebecca, Dean, is she gonna cry? Just cry. Alright. This is officially... I don't know. We'll see how this plays out, but I'm pretty stoked about it. She doesn't know why she's crying. It's because she's happy to see Dean again. So, is it going to be Kamazots? Or Calavos, rather? Because that's when Calavos interrupts the conversation. There's a magical beast! Yep, Calibos. Classic Wild Arms 5. Gem! Alright, lovely, he's Cecilia. Let's tear this apart. It doesn't look like there's any encounter avoidance. It'd be fine if you could just hug the wall and not get the encounters. Alright, Calibos. Let's see what's up. Oh. Alright. It's not gonna instantly kill it anyways. Give it some of the Rebecca Rocket. Oh, Ampan's yelling to stop. Stop attacking! Calibos is my friend! Oh, he's giving off explosive. Wonder if that was a Wild Arms 2 thing. Run away! Wait. We actually run away? Well, we did not run away, but it's probably fine. Gems! Of Lady Cecilia, so they'll be friends. Alright, we'll complete this chapter and then we'll be done. Run away! Calibos is somehow still alive. Is this where Dean gets his arms? Seems about right. She dropped him. Imagine if there was a time loop where she didn't drop the arms. And none of that happened. It probably would have ended up happening. Just, you know. She would have given the arms to Dean at some point, probably. Are those arms important? Yes, very important. Alright then. Leave it to me. Is he gonna double jump? Or he's gonna yell, "Rebecca, trust me." Dean, why you be crazy? Meteor Drive! Meteora Diva. Oh no, the Black Fender! Oh, are you gonna do the Meteor Dive too? That's how you do a Meteor Drive. Alright, that's pretty good. They know the same technique. Just kill it here. Not sure why we didn't just do it earlier, but now we got Dean with his arms. So let's roll. I wonder if they got Nana Mizuki. Or Rebecca's voice. Or if it's someone else. Would Nana Mizuki be in a game where she doesn't do the theme song? Yes, one of the best RPG on PS1. Might look a bit different though. This is a recent release. It's not in the Twitch database, which is why I have my game set to Wild Arms 1. It is the Wild Arms mobile game. Let's give him some arms. Doesn't seem to. Okay, yeah, it did damage. Okay. Yeah, this is an action RPG. You play it with touchscreen controls. I have it mapped to a PS4 controller now, so it plays a bit better. I disagree. I think my timing was perfect on that. There we go. It's over! So we got a Google Translate overlay. So we're getting a general idea of what's going on. But not a perfect translation. Yeah, it's very mobile, very gacha. Only an A rank. Your rank is based on how fast you complete it. We did take a while to kill that boss, though. So makes sense. Okay, a couple more scenes and we'll be done for the night. And I'm gonna upload all these to YouTube just so. Once this game is no longer existing, we'll still have the memories. A million of them. And we're also kind of working on a translation thing. Alright, we got out of the tomb successfully. My ears are fine. But Ririti's tomb is buried. Yeah, I'm liking the combat now that I got the PS4 controller mapped out. I wish they provide native support for controllers, but... Dean's like, I'll give these back. They're important to you, right? But Avro's like, nah, you keep them. You were meant to have them. Yeah, hand pan looks a bit better. Dean stoked about being able to keep the arms. Hey boy! Yeah, I like the graphical style of all the characters. Yeah, like maybe those arms that Dean has are the absolute power. But, Jack isn't an arm wielder. It's weird that they can't call the weapons arms, because arms mean something else in this game. So they're just like, that weapon there, that's not an arm. Oh, they're asking for a name. I'm Avril. Thank you, Avril. Cecilia's like, so why was I called here? Oh, she's gonna return to her house. In quotations. You're not gonna join us, Cecilia? Doesn't know why she went to Lilithia's tomb. Translation bot explodes. But she's like, yeah, I enjoyed our adventure, even though I don't know why I was called to go here. But Cecilia knows that she won't be able to adventure anymore now that she's princess. Please don't treat her differently once you see her at the festival. Because they don't know she's a princess yet, but she will once they see her at the festival. Where nothing bad will happen. We got Dean. We got Jim. Wait, did I just go to the next quest? It's taking a while to get that last two. Starting to think that might have locked up. I think it might have locked up. Wild Arms, Million Memories. Yep, this is Wild Arms. If you haven't seen the opening, well, we can watch the opening real quick. It's a good way to bookend this stream, I guess. Let's go with that. Yeah, the original OP is the best. This is just a whole lot of fan service. But Quarter Knights. We're not sure how this plays into the plot. At best, it's a part of the time loop from Wild Arms 5. Spoilers, but... So this is a separate timeline. And somehow all of the games are... in the same world. So yeah, separate timeline. It's a simple way to think about it. Truly it was. Million Memory. Wild Arms! Million Memories! Yeah, let's see if we complete any missions. See what our gacha count's at. Probably not gonna get Pumpkin Cecilia, just not enough time. Now the caravan is a train, but it has wheels. Weird. That means it doesn't need tracks, though. Hey, you get to see your main party and the current theme. as the background. So Halloween right now. Get all my gems. Get all my gems. Alright, got all my gems. So 270, so halfway to another 11 pull. So there's the Cecilia Gacha. Then Pumpkin Cecilia. Oh, the choices. Then we have to find a way to get. Or is there anything that we haven't got? We got that, we got that, we got that. So we got all the important stuff from that catch anyway. But yeah, that's it for this stream. These are the five characters we have so far. Yeah, it's ridiculous, the gacha. I hope they reduce the cost, because it's ludicrous. Still got 9 chapters. Oh, we just completed 5? We didn't complete 6? Oh, did it not count? Alright, fine, we'll do a scene. Watch this scene, because apparently we're not done with chapter 6. Okay, there's one more scene, apparently. There's no guarantees, except in the Cecilia one, I think there's a guarantee at some point. Oh, what? Are you telling me Alexia is the same, a sister of Cecilia in this world? Or is it separate princess? Separate princess, probably. Not relative, huh? I don't know what's going on anymore. I'm gonna guess she's a visiting princess here for the festival. She's from Lesius, which I guess is the country from Wild Arms XF, so she's gonna be, or that country exists in this world. And her father's still alive. Lesia and Sinatahide are... so they're from the same bloodline. I think. So distant relatives. She wants to study and hang out with Cecilia. Ta-da! Sorry for going on an adventure. Alexia is freaking out about something. Not sure what she's talking about. Francis Sui will be Alexia's guide. So his father is all like, you could learn from Alexia because she's cool and you're not. But he'll be dead soon, so it's all good. Alright, that should be it. Gym. Alright, so we have 7, 8, and 9 left, but that'll be for a later date.